You're listening to Marketing Tips with Melis podcast.
Welcome to Marketing Tips with Melis podcast. And now your host, Melis Jakubovic.
Hello, 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 everybody, and welcome. Today is going to be a very short episode slash live, depending on if you are watching this live on Facebook or tuning in to the Marketing Tips with Melis podcast. So thanks for being on. In case you don't know me, my name is Melis Jakubovic. I'm an online marketing strategist and Facebook ad expert to health and life coaches and healers. And I help you scale your business in 90 days or less. And today we are talking about pivoting. Do you think of Ross and Chandler when you hear the word pivot? Pivot! Maybe it's just me. But anyway, all joking aside, we have a lot of craziness going on in our world right now, and that affects our personal lives, but it also affects our business. And when we see a change in business, this is a time to recognize as a business owner that we might also need to adapt. And pivoting during this pandemic is watching people shift their businesses or meet the changes that are required as a result of mandates and lockdowns and all the other crazy stuff that's going on in our life. So when it comes to pivoting, it can be very, very scary because you've been doing something that's been working for you for a really long time, and now you need to change. And change is hard. Change is scary. But change can also be an opportunity for some really great stuff. The power of the pivot has always been an important part of your mindset in your business. This is where you're talking to your ideal target market. You find out that maybe what you've been saying hasn't really been resonating and it's time to shift. Maybe the package or the pricing that you've been offering really isn't selling as well as you had hoped. And so it's time to shift. Excuse me. All right. Say hello as you're hopping on in. I see a lot of you are on. Give me some love, hearts, and likes so I know that you are here. Thanks for being on. So when we are talking about pivoting, we are talking about recognizing what the market needs us to do prior to us making that shift. And sometimes we can't predict, often we can't predict, although I do have a lot of intuitive healers here, so maybe you guys can predict, but you can't predict what's going to happen until you feel that pull. And when you feel that pull, that's when there's a shakeup. That's when we know we're in the middle of a transition. And the greatest things that happen in our life happen on the other side of that transition. So if this is happening in your business, that doesn't mean it's time to quit. It means it's time to maybe survey the audience and find out what they need, or maybe just switching and tweaking a few little things so that you can stay on top. Sometimes we can be stuck in a rut and we don't even realize it. We're doing the same thing day in, day out, and things aren't converting as well as they used to. And this is when, as a business owner, you need to take a step back and give like a bird's eye view to what's going on. Maybe you need to hire a marketing strategist or a coach to come in and really have a good look at what's going on. But you need to have a bird's eye view of the overall picture to say, all this is good, but right there and there, we need to just tweak those little things and it can make a massive shift in your business. So to get your business to the next level, you need to identify what is and what isn't working. And that's where the pivot comes in. I hope that makes sense. So what can a pivot look like? It can come in the form of changing or even narrowing down your niche. And I know that's scary because when you narrow yourself down, the mindset is, my gosh, how am I going to help everybody if I'm only helping this small amount of people? Now I'm not going to have as many clients, but that's actually not true. It's counterintuitive. The more niched you can become, the more of an expert in your industry you can become, and therefore you can attract more and more of your ideal target market and repel the people that don't fit. So when you attract people, you are going to repel others, and that's okay. In fact, that is what you want. You want the people that you can help the most to come to you and see you as the expert or the authority in your industry and say, I've heard all about you and you're amazing because you do this and this and this for people just like me. Can you help me? And that happens by narrowing down your market. Maybe you're scared to do it because you've been helping one particular type of market for some time and now you're ready to shift. guess what? The best way to do it is just to shift. Your marketing messaging will change a little bit. If you have an email list, you can slowly ease them into the new direction that you're going and just shift. You've got to pivot into what makes you feel in the most alignment possible.
Do you get so discouraged without the support that you need when it comes to attracting clients and filling your programs? My new program is going to solve that without breaking the bank. For a limited time, you can join my Acceleration Club and gain instant access to my best 3 selling courses: How to Build a Killer Content Calendar, List Building Brilliance, and the Funnel Formula. Plus, you get bi-weekly support from me for the rest of the year with our acceleration calls. Visit acceleration club.com right now.
Also, refining your marketing strategy. Maybe you're only running Facebook ads. Maybe you're only doing organic marketing. Maybe you're only on one platform and you want to be on another. You really have to figure out what it is that you need to do that is money-generating activity. What can you delegate? What can you keep on your plate? And what can you take off your plate because you just don't need it anymore? It just doesn't serve you anymore. Even if you've been doing it for 5 years, if it doesn't serve you today anymore, it's okay to say goodbye to it. It's okay to move forward and go in a different direction. So you really need to refine the marketing strategy and figure out what is working, what isn't working, what you're willing to put up with, what you're willing to change, and what you really want to keep the way that it is. And then the last thing could be starting a joint venture, maybe having a collaboration call with someone who shares a similar audience to you, or maybe it's two people, you and someone else, who are collaborating in maybe a telesummit or a program that you offer or a course or something, so you guys can work together and you can move together forward. Two heads are better than one. But creating a joint venture can really help build and boost your business, because now you have another market and you have access to another market. So if you're maybe in the health and wellness field and you're helping children with their eating habits, and you know somebody else who's in the health and wellness field who are helping adults with their eating habits, and you wanna combine forces, you might be able to combine some sort of program that helps families with their eating habits. Or maybe you have a target market of virtual assistants, as I do, who work with spiritual and holistic style businesses. And then there's someone else who wants to teach virtual assistants on how to grow their business. So we may have similar markets, but we do very different things. So we can share our audiences together and everyone can build and grow. So regardless of where you are in your business, you can always pivot. You can always make the choice to release what is no longer serving you. And the main thing is to just identify what is needed in your business. And then intuitively feel what feels good. Where do you want to go and how do you want to get there? If you've been feeling stuck in your business and you want to take things to the next level, this might be a good time to reach out to me, because this is what I do. And I help you get unstuck. I help you shake things up. I help you reach that next level in your business. And I step in as a third party looking at a bird's eye view of your business to see what needs to be tweaked. So I hope this helps, and I'll see you next time. Bye.
Do you struggle with posting content on social media? Is it difficult to show up consistently? Or maybe you're overwhelmed by what to post where. That's why I created my complete content strategy toolkit, a comprehensive digital toolkit to efficiently and consistently create meaningful content that converts. My toolkit is packed with over $3,000 worth of tools, and the best part, I'm offering it all for the price of one dinner. Go check it out now at AbundantStrategy.com.
Thanks for listening to the Marketing Tips with Melissa podcast at www.marketingtipswithmelissa.com.
Hey, coaches and healers, it's time to feel supported in your business. Head on over to our free community to get access to my best resources for free. I'm talking marketing tips, business strategy, feedback, and so much more. Join now at magneticmarketingmastermind.com. See you there.